The Law of the Legendary Popcorn Sutton. Almost everyone who grew up in and around Cobb County, Tennessee, is familiar with the legend of Popcorn Sutton. Some view him as a folk hero, others view him as a criminal. Still, his name is with one of the country's greatest claims to fame. Real mountain moonshine. Popcorn was a moonshiner who was born in Maggie Valley, North Carolina. In fact, he came from a long line of bootleggers. He considered moonshining his birthright. Popcorn learned to make moonshine at an early age. He honed the perfection of the craft, much like his father and grandfather had before him. While Popcorn made his career out of this illegal trade, his rise to massive fame didn't happen until he was almost 60 years old. Popcorn appeared in several documentaries, including This Is the Last Damn Run of Liquor I'll Ever Make. He was also known for being convicted of crimes related to moonshining and illegal firearm possessions. Since his passing, his fame has only become more widespread, with a new whiskey company that bears his name and numerous mentions on Discovery Channel's popular show, Moonshiners. According to filmmaker Neil Hutchison, Popcorn remains an intriguing figure. Hutchison's coffee table book style biography, The Moonshiner Popcorn Sutton, is a glimpse into Popcorn's wit, jokes, and hillbilly way of life. The book also offers a better understanding of how people of the region survived. But how well do you really know the legend of Popcorn Sutton? The Life Behind the Legend new book explores life and legacies of moonshiner Popcorn Sutton. At the end of his life, Marvin Popcorn Sutton was reverted as a folk hero, a rebel, and is still referred to as the King of moonshine. And even though it has been almost 14 years since his death, Popcorn Sutton still remains a major public figure. But there was a lot more to Popcorn than just moonshine. At least that's what author and filmmaker Neil Hutchison explained. Hutchison, who worked with Sutton in creating several major documentaries about his life, describes Popcorn as not only a complex character, but a truly gifted and fascinating craftsman. He was also an incredible performer and was really savvy about people and what they wanted and being able to deliver it to them, Hutchison said. It was a lot of fun being around him. More and more, I would visit with him, just enjoying the opportunity to be around him. After he began to trust me more and more, he allowed me to visit his home in East Tennessee and see his big moonshine operation. I remember thinking, wow, this is something most people don't ever get to see. And after getting to know Sutton over the years, Hutchison said he felt compelled to write the book as a final tribute to him before he moved on from the subject. I want readers to have a deeper appreciation for who he was, Hutchison said. I feel like the book shows him in both good and bad lights. Yes, there were some character flaws mentioned in there, but I got to experience his most generous qualities. The Moonshiner, Popcorn Sutton, captures the true story of the man behind the legend for the first time in extensive personal interviews, exclusive behind-the-scenes photography, first-hand remembrances, and vital history content. Popcorn's ancestors settled in Cataloochee in the Great Smoky Mountains by hunting, farming, foraging, and distilling whiskey. The Suttons relied on traditional knowledge and skills to survive. When Popcorn was born in 1946, Appalachia had not been developed with hard surface roads, cars, rural electrification, radio, or television. Survival during that time period required knowing the mountains. By mixing the pure, cold, abundantly flowing mountain water with liquid from rotten corn and distilling it through whatever pieces of metal he found, Popcorn learned to operate in a gray area between social approval and legal consequences. Hutchison writes in his book, "That was how Popcorn began his legacy of being a moonshiner and a bootlegger, which later became an empire." Throughout his life, Sutton proudly held on to his Scottish / Irish American heritage and boasted about the fact that he had moonshining in his blood. In Hutchison's book, Sutton was quoted saying, "I've dug ditches, I've worked on construction, I've done everything, and there ain't nothing no harder than what I'm doing. But it's just in my blood." Sutton earned massive fame as a liquor king by the time he turned 60. In 1999, he launched his self-published autobiography, Me and My Liquor, which also chronicled the incredible journey of moonshine production. He published the book at his junk shop in Maggie Valley. In January 2009, Sutton was charged with illegal distillation of spirits and firearm possession. He pleaded guilty and was sentenced to 18 months of federal imprisonment. Just 2 months later, Sutton committed suicide. It was said he did this to avoid the federal prison term that was supposed to start a few days later. Additionally, Sutton had also had a mental breakdown after being diagnosed with cancer. Just a year after Sutton died, moonshining was legalized in the U.S. About the author, Neil Hutchison is an award-winning filmmaker with a large body of documentary heritage in transition. Hutchison's documentary, Mountain Talk, featured Popcorn Sutton among many other citizens of Western North Carolina, and he subsequently produced two documentaries featured with Sutton, the Emmy Award-winning The Last One from 2009, and Popcorn Sutton, A Hell of a Life, in 2014. However, ladies and gentlemen, that is all I have today on the legendary moonshiner, Mr. Popcorn Sutton. I have the links to the books posted in the description. This video is not sponsored by anyone, and all of my research has been done on the internet. Thank y'all for watching. I hope y'all enjoyed. Until next time, Godspeed.